coming in town. Baby girl holding me down, yeah. Yeah, she a 10, a little bit crazy, but nothing my ass cannot handle. Best so cowgirl.
What's up, guys? Good morning, good afternoon, good night. Whatever it is for you, I hope you're having a great day today. Welcome back to the vlog. Today is a work day, just jam-packed. Gotta get everything done by the time the store's closed tonight, because tomorrow, as I said in yesterday's vlog, is the Parish Festival. It's the first one that we're ever going to. I think this is like the third or fourth that they're doing. We're actually volunteering at the festival tomorrow. So since I'm part of Life Teen, I'm gonna be possibly getting pulled aside to work the cotton candy machine, the snow cone machine, and the popcorn machine for a little bit throughout the day. Gonna enjoy some of the games, some of the fun that they got around, see the entertainment. There's supposed to be like a bird show or something that I'm gonna definitely film, because that'd be pretty cool. There's gonna be a dunk tank. I'm not gonna be in the dunk tank. That's something that the kids that are still in high school do. If I was gonna be in the dunk tank, I would have all of my action camera stuff together, and I would definitely be filming me getting dunked probably a million times. But at least tomorrow it's gonna be warm, because last year supposedly they hated it because it was freezing out on that day. I didn't go, but I heard from people that were actually in the tank and they said it was the worst idea ever to do because it was like 40 degrees outside.
I don't know if you guys can really tell or not, probably right there, but last week when I went and did that pig roast, we were working with bleach to clean the dishes. Like, it was a mixture of bleach and dish soap to clean, and then you rinsed it all off. But I think I got some bleach on my shoelaces. I was like, are you kidding me?
You said we had it all. That shit would drive me crazy. Cause outside, outside, there's no feelings, baby. You say it's hard to tell what I've been thinking lately. But behind closed doors, I'm a fool for your love. Her last semester's over. Parents in Minnesota, Chicago's.
We were probably about 5 to 10 minutes ago headed over to the city right now. But in a previous vlog a few weeks ago, when I got my new pair of sunglasses at Route 21, I told you guys that watch, I would find the pair that I lost, like the wood, like cheetah print or whatever, a couple of weeks later. Yeah, they appeared out of nowhere a couple of days ago. So it just, it always happens that way. I don't know why, but it just does. Just made it into the city, but kind of in a rush at this point because it's after 4:30 and this store closes at 5 o'clock because it's in downtown. Somehow got everything done before they closed. We were already here earlier in the week doing work, so not much to really do here, just a quick in and out. But time to go do the rest of the stores. I'm not sure how much more I'm gonna be able to film right now because my battery looks like it's about ready to go, and I did not bring it back. That wasn't me at all.
I've been following your trail, you don't hide it well. Yeah, I should have played it safe, kept my eye on you, but I didn't. Now your venom's in my bloodstream. Yeah, you got me exposed, then you dug deep. Ooh. Cobra, cobra, cold-blooded, no love. I let you in, shed my skin.
Daylight is gone and we are done with work for tonight. Gonna head home right now and figure out what is going on for the rest of the evening. About to sit down for dinner. We got some corn with melted butter here, pork chops with garlic and onion powder on them, and then we got a new type of pasta here. This is cheesy cheddar pasta. We've never had this before. Something a little different. I'll let you guys know how that tastes. I'm sure tomorrow when I go to Walmart after church, we will probably see this in the vlog. But one of the people that I'm friends with on Facebook just posted this. He lives in a different state and they've already got all the Christmas trees up. I thought, oh, we're gonna get a little lucky this year and they're gonna wait till October. Nope, not even October yet.
Old friends switched up, now seems like they never believed in me. Hit my girl, hit my phone late night, she gone and she leaving me. Every day life changes, but one thing I know is I'm far from basic. Yeah, next time they call, I'ma duck 'em. Cause if they ain't fucking with me, then fuck 'em. Had some old friends switching up like a light switch. These days it ain't hard to tell who I'm tight with.
I have had a pretty awesome night tonight. First off, when I got home, checked the baseball scores because I didn't have a chance to do that while I was at work, and found out the Yankees clinched a playoff berth. I am so happy that they're back in the postseason. 2017 October baseball here. We come Right now, it's just a wild card spot. Still a possibility for the division, but, you know, if it doesn't happen, it doesn't happen. I'm just happy that they're back in the playoffs. Dream is always the World Series and winning championship number 28, so I cannot wait to see what they do this year in October. Second off, got down to rehearsing some brand new music, and it's coming out so good right now. I cannot wait to start posting this stuff for you guys. Still trying to figure out the whole non-acapella type music stuff. I don't have the equipment, obviously, right now, but trying to make it work with what I do have. Always trying to live by the motto of, you don't gotta go out and buy the most expensive equipment that there is to make the best stuff. Use the best thing that you have at your disposal right now. So really just trying to figure all of that stuff out before I start recording these videos and everything for you guys. And then the third and final thing is I got to talk a little bit on Twitter with one of my fellow musicians. His name is Alex Angelo. He is way bigger than me when it comes to followers. You know, he DM'd me his new song. He DMs all of his fans his new songs, and he, you know, personalizes the messages, which I think is really awesome that he does that kind of stuff. But I went and listened to it, and I was like, dude, this is really, really good. I love this music. And then I said to him, I cannot wait to start making music like you do someday. When it about 5 minutes passed, he DMs me back, and he's like, why wait? Start now. And that really hit me. And it made me think, you know what? Tip of the day. That's what this has got to turn into. What I want to leave you with is, don't sit back and just dream and say, I can't wait to do that. Say, I want to do that right now. I'm going to make it happen. I'm going to do whatever it takes to get where I want to be. Does not matter if you're the crappiest singer in the world. Go out, go online, take some online courses, do the vocal exercises, get a voice teacher. If you're not the best songwriter in the world, take some online courses for that. Practice writing some songs. You're gonna write a lot of crappy songs. I know I have. I'm still writing crappy songs at this point. I've performed a lot of my horrible songs for people in it, and it did not turn out well. Probably not the best decision in the world, but you know, it was a little bit of a learning experience for me. And you know, one day you're gonna write a really awesome song, and somebody's gonna go, I really like that, because you decided to give it a chance and perform that song for them. And then you're gonna end up recording that song, and you're gonna end up getting fans off of that song, and you're gonna end up performing a small concert, and then people are really gonna like you, and your fan base is gonna grow, and you're gonna be able to perform bigger concerts and then go on tour and all this other stuff and albums and, you know, all this craziness. And I sound like a complete buffoon going way beyond anything that anybody could ever imagine and going beyond a realm of possibility for a lot of people. But you know what? I live by a quote all the time, and that is, if your dreams do not scare you, they're not big enough. I always dream out of the realm of possibility. I always dream the impossible, because if I'm not scared, I'm not trying. I'm always scared with these dreams of me one day being up on stage in front of thousands of people and performing sold out shows, having my own albums, and having fans that I truly love, that I love to put smiles on their faces and just really inspire them to want to do the same things or live their dreams out. That scares me so much, because I'm afraid that I'm gonna fail. I'm afraid that I'm not gonna try, and it makes me motivated, and it makes me want to go out and try even harder to achieve those dreams. Now, I know, like, I've given up on music like a couple of months ago, but now I'm motivated to get back into it. The same thing with film, the same thing with photography. I'm motivated to get in. It doesn't matter what your dream is, you just gotta make it bigger than anything else in the world. It does not matter if your dream seems impossible right now. With a lot of hard work, a lot of dedication, a lot of motivation, and a lot of help from the big man upstairs right there, you will get there some. It takes time, but it also takes you to jumpstart it right now. So go out there, live your dreams, put a smile on your face, scare the crap out of yourself, because your dreams are so big that you probably got people telling you you're crazy, but it doesn't matter, because that's what you want in life. That is pretty much gonna wrap it up for today. I wanna thank you guys so much for watching. If there are any brand new viewers out there watching, I wanna welcome you right now to this channel right here. If you did love this video and you so desire to, slap a like on it, and don't forget to turn those post notifications on down below, so that way you never miss when I upload any video to this channel. Also, while you're down there, if you haven't already, and I don't understand why you haven't clicked that big red subscribe button so you never miss out on any new content and you get all this amazing stuff that I'm going to be talking about over the rest of time. And I'll see you guys tomorrow with another brand new daily vlog. We got the Parish Festival ahead. It's gonna be pretty awesome. Remember to stay awesome, keep smiling. You're beautiful, and I love you guys so much. Peace out, YouTube. I think I'm falling for my Zion.
falling for my side, falling for my side, falling for my side, falling for my side, chick. Now I really wanna kick it, I get it, but each time.